You are listening to The Centropic Oracle, an audiobook podcast of science fiction and fantasy short stories that make you think and feel. The Hat Thing by Matthew Hughes.
See that? Medgar said. You see how he handled the hat thing?
What hat thing? I said.
He wound the tape back and said, watch.
I watched. Gene Wilder, in a neat gray suit and wide-brimmed fedora, knocked on the front door of a big stone house. A woman in a servant's uniform opened the door. There was some dialogue, and the woman tried to close the door, but the actor put his foot in the way and said something.
Now watch, Medgar said.
The video cut to a scene shot from inside the foyer of the house. Wilder came in and took off his hat.
There, said Medgar. That was the way it was done.
The way what was done? I said.
The whole business with hat etiquette.
What's hat etiquette?
It's why he doesn't take his hat off, and then he does.
My face must have told him I had no idea what he was talking about.
Look, he said, this movie is set in the 1930s, right? And Wilder plays a gentlemanly character, a theater director with good manners.
Okay, so?
So when she answers the door, he doesn't take his hat off, even though you're supposed to take your hat off when you meet a woman, but he doesn't.
Why not?
Because she's just the maid. If she'd been the lady of the house, the hat would have come off.
But he takes it off when he goes inside, I said.
'Cause you did when you went into somebody's house. That's old-style hat etiquette. Like, you go into a restaurant, it's hats off. You go into a bar, it stays on.
I see people wearing baseball caps in restaurants all the time.
Yeah, now, he said. Go back 50, 60 years, you didn't.
And this has to do with what? I said.
With time travel. Specifically with time travelers.
Time travelers?
Yeah, he said. Assume that someday somebody invents time travel.
Yeah, right.
Hey, give people a million years to look into it, who knows?
I shrugged and didn't say anything.
The thing is, he went on, time travel only has to be invented once, and then we'll have time travelers showing up all through history, not to mention visits to see dinosaurs and saber-tooths.
Would anyone really want to travel through time? I said.
Sure. Researchers, tourists, criminals altering their present by manipulating the past, religious pilgrims, collectors. Who knows what motivates people in a million years from now?
I shrugged again.
The thing is, Medgar said, the further back they come, the less likely they get all the details right. The little things like hat etiquette that nobody in the future knows because nobody in the past ever wrote it down.
Why didn't they?
Because everybody already knew what to do with their hats.
I tried to change the subject. Who did you vote for on that TV show? But he wouldn't let it go.
No, listen, here's the thing. You know the people you see downtown? You wonder, did they just come down from the mothership?
Those people are mentally ill, I said.
Sure, most of them. But maybe one or two are the earliest explorers from 1 million AD. They're the ones who did the first reconnaissance so that the later time travelers can blend in better.
You don't talk about this kind of stuff to people you work with, do you? I asked. Or your other neighbors?
No, I just thought of it. Anyway, the latecomers are pretty well camouflaged, but there will still be things that will be out of sync, like the hat thing. We look for that stuff, we can find the time travelers.
I took out a cigarette and tapped one end of it against the back of my hand, then put it in my mouth.
Hey, yeah, he said, that's a good one. People haven't done the ciggy tap since everybody switched to filters.
He laughed. Then he saw the look on my face. Sorry, I said, although a moment later he was a lot sorrier. I put his ashes in a plastic sack and carried it out to the chute. Then I went back for the Wilder tape. Somebody upslope would want to study it.
We hope you enjoyed The Hat Thing by Matthew Hughes, read by Larissa Thompson. If you'd like to learn more about the author and narrator of this story or make a donation to them, follow the story page link in the description. Pledge your support to us on Patreon for cool rewards and to help us bring you more stories. If you would like to submit a story for consideration or apply to be a narrator, a link to our submission guidelines is in the description.